What's going on, guys? Welcome back. It's Alex Miller, Rampage of 78 Designs here. Today we're going to be doing a Halloween Kills Neca figure review, but also some of the sculpt modifications that I did here. And here we go. So I did a backdrop here, just basically burnt walls and fake picture on the wall I painted, which is pretty cool, actually. So this is him. This is my custom. The face needed major rework. It looks okay, I guess. This is, you know, what I came up with. This is what I felt looked more accurate. I worked on the coveralls. I did some firefighter bodies as well. As you can see, we have all the accessories here. Comes with a Halligan bar, which is used in the fire department and police departments for forcible entry. Comes with the kitchen knife and the light tube. And I made another carcass there. This is a pumpkin I sculpted a long time ago. Scarred pumpkin. One thing that this did come with that was pretty damn cool. It has a background, which is kind of hard to get right if you're actually going to use it. I'm not sure if it's supposed to be a background for the figure, but yeah, that was pretty badass. Okay, so we'll take a look at the head now. If my camera will focus. I added to the ear. I added to everything. The mouth, the nose. Not the nose, actually. That might be the only thing I didn't add. Eyes, I re-sculpted. I did the forehead. This thing is such a crazy good figure, but it's like, he's stiff right now because he's new, so it's hard to get these things to fucking stand and all that properly. He's gonna fall backwards any second now. But yeah. Okay, so I guess what I'll do now is put some different weapons in his hand and go from there. Really nice. I love the figure on the detail on the clothes and stuff like that. I'm not going to spare you. I'm going to spare you and just not do the box. The box art is fantastic, but it's in most, you know, videos. We already have those. All right, so let's get to it. Okay, so we're back here, and actually what I've done with the firefighter is I sculpted the face. Let me get the light here better for you. To be so the Halligan bar could fit in with him. Into the face, rather. Jeez. And there's also a hole in his neck. So you can reverse the pole and put, you know, the pike piece. Spike piece, we call it pike, but for people who aren't on the FD, the pike piece, you know, the spike piece could go right in his throat if you want. Very cool figure. So yeah, the bullet wound was like way up by the ear. I had to fix that. And yeah, so why don't I just go ahead now and get some more angles, I guess, of the figure without. Oh, looks like I didn't put that hand on that great. Oh, yeah, I did, actually. I love the articulation, man. It's so. He's gonna fall. Your head, you're dead, anyways. Yeah, so. I mean, as you can see, quite a bit of modifications to the sculpt there. Lovely. Well, yeah, it's a lovely, fantastic, beautiful figure, I think. The thing is sick. Even without my sculpt mods, I can't do. If it's too inaccurate, I can't do it. I really can't. So I had to fix some things. Like, there's... Oop. Put the light on in the room. There's three signature imprint burn marks that are on the cheek here that are kind of on the Neca figure, but it's, like, weird. I'm not sure why this is not focusing. I wanna... How do you... You guys know, as I said in other videos, I'm not the best YouTuber. Yeah, but... So... It was just weird. It just had, like, burn mess everywhere. Black mess everywhere, you know what I mean? So he needed to be fixed in a major way. That's a pretty cool shot. Yeah. So that's it. I guess I could do, if somebody wants some, I could mold this, I guess, if somebody wants. And therefore you'd have it. I could paint it too, I guess. But this is just like a one-off. I didn't mold this. It's just, the Neca sculpt. I'm not sure if I'd want to do that, though. I don't want to get in trouble or anything. But whatever. I am a mask maker. I'm not, I don't usually do this figure stuff, so... Let's go ahead and move him. You know what? Let's get some, we'll do some light tube picks after this. I like that. That's a cool shot, too. We'll do some light tube pictures, then I'll probably close out the video. I mean, you guys have seen all the pictures with the Neca figures with this. Granted, it's not with my, overhaul, but, or redo of the figure, but okay, let's get to the light tube pictures. Okay, here's light tube Myers. As you can see, the background's kind of tough. Obviously, it's way too tall for him anyways. If you really wanted, realistically, it'd have to be like this. Ooh, that kind of looks cool. Ready? Hold on a second. I'm just having fun with you guys here. Sorry if this isn't like a normal, traditional YouTube video. I just like to point and shoot here. Yeah. Really cool stuff. Oh, that's fantastic. Utterly fantastic. So, I added more blood in the shoulders. I added, if you want to know how to do this effect on the shoulder here, I use crazy glue, and I dab it with a paintbrush so it gets, like, tacky. And then I use a very diluted white on it, and it weathers it. I've weathered his whole coveralls. Okay. Let's go to this side. Okay. Alright, let's put a knife in there. Okay, last but not least, I did the... This light is too harsh here. I did the pose where he picks the knife out of the kitchen drawer and he's kind of looking at it. And walks away with it. Yeah. Thank you guys for watching this video. Very fun doing this stuff, of course. I do have flashback kills coming out. Halloween flashback kills. Halloween extra flashback kills, rather. We did Halloween extra kills. Now I'll do extra flashback with the new mask that I have coming out. And I will do a video on the current new mask flashback that I did. But it's immediately been retooled, and it's a little smaller. This, the one I have now is a great size, though. It's only like 24, 24 and a half. So if you want one of those, let me know. But for now, thank you for watching, guys. I hope everyone has a fantastic day. Peace.